EMF is about these four parts: electric fields, magnetic fields, RF, and dirty power. At this date, it is still common that people only check for RF and not the rest. And then some people complain they still have bad reactions to their TV. It's because they didn't do a complete check. If you ignore one of these parts, you can miss something. My first concern about TVs is so-called dirty power or dirty electricity, also known as EMI. I will demonstrate how I test for this. It can be useful to test for dirty electricity with a device like this. I like to test in stores first before ordering, especially in dirty magnetic mode. I go up and down about 2 inches from the screen. It's important that the sound function is off for this test. This TV looks to be in a good category here, meaning it looks like it emits low dirty magnetic. But in the corner here it measures higher, so this may still be a red flag. This is what you definitely don't want. This is very high for this distance. Up close, the levels are extreme. Not many TVs will emit this high. It comes from my old plasma TV that I filmed here in 2018. This is a very high value. This is also way too high at this distance. And the noise comes from this radio. But when the TV is turned off, you can hear the noise go away, and the value dropped to zero on this device. This value dropped a lot as well. Next up, you will see a test using a special video I designed that switches between dark and light on a Star Wars rhythm, which forces the EMF in a recognizable pattern. Read the subtitles for info. Then I tried this TV. Over 400 millivolts, dirty electricity is still a bit high. Be aware that you can only test with a device like this if the dirty electricity is low enough in your house. If you already have high dirty electricity without even plugging a TV in, then you may not be able to test. You must have a relatively low base level to see it rise and drop. Testing in stores will be impossible with this device for the same reason. This TV has levels that are not that bad compared to the previously tested TVs. But you also need to pay attention to the noise. Some settings may increase or decrease dirty electricity a bit, but this may not be enough to turn a bad TV in a good one. This is a bit noisy, but you must check if the noise comes from the TV or was already there to begin with, coming from neighbors. The dirty electricity increases when this TV is turned on, but then it will drop again when this TV is playing. When this TV is running, it is actually not that bad, and I don't hear much noise. So I think, dirty electricity wise, this is fairly acceptable for a large TV at this date. It will be hard to find something better. When dirty magnetic is low on that white device I used previously, I noticed that the values were often low on this dirty electricity meter as well. So with that white device, I tested TVs in stores and it made it easier for me to end up with a relatively low dirty electricity TV. I can't guarantee this always works, there may be factors that can be overlooked, but in my case this method was helpful. For more details about that method, read the information below this video. This TV is set to make connection through a cable. If we look at what they call expert settings, we can see that the Wi-Fi is turned off, but we measure Wi-Fi. You can see that it does not make much difference if you change settings here. This is not a bug, they make it so. You can't disable Wi-Fi on this TV, but on LG TVs, for example, I tried the same and it did work. When the TV itself is turned off, it's still not going away. On TVs like these, the only way to get rid of this is to open the back panel and hopefully find a cable to the Wi-Fi circuit board and disconnect that. High electric fields are often caused by these two-prong plugs. But devices should come with a plug that grounds electric fields. Some TVs ground completely or partly through a HDMI cable connected to another device. But if you don't do this, a TV can emit a very strong electric field. This device is maxed out in this electric mode. So I needed to switch to the electric mode for stronger fields. The strong electric field is now completely gone. Measuring with ground cable, the values drop when closing in because the TV is now grounded. There are many products these days that come with a two-prong plug, this TV as well. On this TV, electric wasn't that bad, but it's better that this is grounded. I did this with a printer cable plugged into an USB port and then connected this alligator clip to it, which is connected to ground. This multimeter is set here to test continuity. I will demonstrate something you can test if you want to ground a device that came with a two-prong plug. If the leads touch each other, you can hear this beep. You can test for continuity between certain metal parts on a device you want to ground. If a device doesn't have a USB connection, you can also ground with a Cat6A cable, for example. I just wound some metal wire touching this metal part. And then you connect an alligator clip to it, connected to some wire connected to ground. The value you see now on this device is always here in my living space. It does not come from the TV. So it's a bit more tricky to say what comes from this TV in this mode and what comes from this living space, unless the value goes up a lot. This TV is probably okay. This device is also very sensitive, but slightly less sensitive than that white device, so it's more clear to see what comes from the TV with this one. Magnetic-wise, this TV is not that bad, I guess. There isn't much magnetic measured from it, about 4 inches from it.